Hello friends, welcome to the Smart Exceller. This video is about how to score full marks or how to give full marks for the things which are in a not applicable stage. So this is a continuation of my video on full marks in the series. This is the second video. So as I showed you in my previous video that if anything is been not applicable, you should get the full marks. So the weightage is this and you should get a full mark. If you have not aware of this, just refer to my previous video and you can make out that the score over here is not a justifiable score, because something is not applicable, we should give a full marks to those. It depends on here. So let me give a continuation of this. So this is the formula which I'll be doing on this. So this is a component of two or more formulas and a mixture with countif and if. So I have made a code for this. This is a VBA code has been written. So this I will be covering in my next forthcoming videos in VBA. So how to write codes and also we can see, we can clear the screen and we can do a evaluate. So when I have something called not applicable and when I do the evaluation, we can see that when I have something is not applicable, the score should be given as full marks. So this should be the score 67.5, but now the score is 42.5. So it is not applicable. We have to get the full marks 25, which is here. So now I'm going to make a simple video where I'm going to make a weightage of 25 only. So it's very easy to understand. So if I make this dependent on this, so it will be a little more complicated. So I will be covering that in my next video. So let's start with this. First, I'm going to show you how to make the section. So I'll be doing bits and pieces. So first, I'll be using a countif formula. Countif is for this range. So if something over here, this is my range, and it has something called not applicable, so it will give the count of that item. Not FPE, so you have to be very careful with the spellings. I will be closing the parenthesis. So you can see once there is not applicable, but if I make this 2, so it comes 2. If I make this 3, it becomes 3, and if I make this 4, it becomes 4. So, and I will be using another formula for the sum. So the sum function is like, you can use the sum formula in two ways. You have to use sum, open the parenthesis, so you can make it one by one, comma this, comma this, comma this, and you can close the parenthesis. Or you can use in one shot with the whole range, you use sum, open the parenthesis and select the whole range and close the parenthesis. So this will give an answer. So this is a right justifiable answer, but I want to make it in a standard professional way. So everybody will be aware of the if condition, so you can refer to my previous video. So I will be not using if condition, I will be using ifs condition. So ifs condition is a more professional way than the if condition. So it is like, I'll be starting with the countif. So I'll be making the same formula again. So this is the range and the criteria is in text, so we should be using the double quotes, not applicable, close the parenthesis. So we don't have anything not applicable. So if I make this not applicable, so I better check the spelling. So the spelling is double P, you can see now it is 1. So if I make this done, so it is going to be 0. So anyhow, if I want to have an if condition, if open the parenthesis, and if the not applicable is equals to 0, if there are 0 not applicables equals to 0, then if it is 0, then I should have a logical test. the logical test will be, if there is no not applicables, I should get the full marks, the full answer. So I should get the sum of this. So it will be like sum, and this will be the answer. So I'll be closing the parentheses and I will be hitting enter. So you can see that you're getting the 42.5%. So this way, this is the first element I have shown in this. So I'll be showing you the next element in the next coming video. I hope you like this video. Please share and subscribe to my channel, and please see that I'm making it in a small bit so it can be easy to understand. So the second series of second video and the third and fourth, and I will be making a complicated on the section of how to get the total from this. So now I'm making 25 because for 25 only, because I want to keep this as simple. So I hope you like this video. Please refer to my second video on this for more information. Thank you for watching.